Welcome to the Scoop School Podcast, where we tackle your conundrums about the retail ice cream and frozen dessert business. And now, here's your host. Don't get him talking. He'll waffle on for hours. The ice cream bloke and self-appointed headmaster of Scoop School, Steve Christensen.
G'day, ice cream lovers. My name's Steve Christensen. Welcome to the podcast. Nice to have you here. Hey, if you are new to the podcast or if you've subscribed to the podcast, we appreciate you being here. I do want to keep you involved in the process, in the giveaways that we have, particularly as we come up to our 100th episode. We're going to go live on our 100th episode, but we do want to have you involved. We're going to give away a sample pack, an extract sample pack worth $100 with vanilla extract, with all sorts of flavors and extracts involved in it. And we're very thankful for all of the episode sponsors. So go to scoopschool.com, click on the podcast tab, fill out the little form there, and you'll go into the running for that extract pack, which we're going to give away on our 100th episode. Now, I do want to thank our episode sponsor here for this episode, which is carpegiani.com. Carpegiani, again, sometimes if I try and speak it into my phone, it'll come up Carpet Johnny. It's not Carpet Johnny, it's no one Johnny, it's Carpegiani. Based in Italy, but selling ice cream equipment all over the world, regardless of whether you need batch freezers, heater mixers, soft serve machines, popsicle machines, they've pretty well got it all. So talk to your local Carpegiani representative or just search Carpegiani in Google. You'll find their website wherever you are in the world, Carpegiani, Carpegiani.com. We thank you for your episode. Have a look at the link down below. Now, I want to talk in this particular episode about systems and accountability. I want to talk in this particular episode about systems and accountability. That was not a glitch in the matrix. I can't say it so many times. Systems and accountability is where you come into the effective and efficient running of your business. You've got to have a system whereby your employees can operate and work within your business, and you must have accountability, or there's going to be no follow-up, there's no drive, there's no framework for your employees to even know what to do and whether there's going to be any follow-up on it. And I'll give you a classic example. So if you've got a task list on the wall, this is our shift change list, so we've got things that need to be done after the end of the first shift coming into the second shift. Also, I've got a manager checklist as well to make sure that all the things are done from the manager's day shift into the evening day shift. Now, if this was just a list in and of itself, and a lot of stores have lists, lists here, lists there, cleaning lists, to-do lists. Honestly, if there's no accountability, that's just a sheet of paper. It's just recommendations. And so you need to have people accountable for what's on that list or the tasks that you would like them to do in your absence or at a particular time during the shift. So I'll give you an example. We used to put this list up on the wall and we used to say to our employees and our assistant managers and managers, look, make sure this is done before the shift ends. And invariably, I'd come in the morning, floor's not mopped, money's not put away properly, things are left out, and it drives you absolutely crazy because the ineffectiveness of the close the night before basically hampers your ability to open the business the next morning, particularly in the ice cream business. So here's what you need to do. You need to have the system. And the system may be all of these different things that you need to do. The accountability portion is to make sure that someone needs to be accountable and sign off for that particular task. So what we did was we took our shift change list, we took our daily prep sheet, we took our close procedure, and we laminated them all, and on the sheet we put a dry erase marker. So at the end of the shift, end of whatever task that they're doing, each particular task has an opportunity for them to sign it. So let's say we're looking at a shift change here, and as it gets closer to the end of the shift, this is to be started 1 hour before the day shift ends. So if my day shift ends at 5 o'clock, 4 o'clock, we need to start going on this list. Okay, so well, the first one is check or empty the trash. If there's not much trash, don't worry checking it out. If it's full, empty it. Now, regardless of whether it's done, whether it's emptied, or whether they've at least checked it, they need to sign off here and say, I've done that. Next one, check levels of caramel and fudge and refill if necessary. Remember, in the ice cream business, you're more than likely, your day shift really is just preparing for the evening shift. So, okay, I've checked my fudge, I'll sign that off. Refill the soda ice dispenser. Julie, can you go and refill the soda ice dispenser? Yes, I can. So when Julie comes back, she'll write Julie in here. Julie did that. And you basically go over, dishes done, sink, mops, buckets put away. Yes, all paper towel, goods restocked, and cone levels checked. All of that's done. Now, you should have a space here for the supervisor or the shift manager to sign off and say, yes, all of that's done. If I come in as the shift manager or as the store owner to run that second shift, and I come in and all of these are checked off, then that's great. That's a great start. But let's say, for example, someone checked off empty the trash, and each one of these trash cans is chock-a-block full. So here's the accountability portion. The accountability on their side was to sign this document or initial it to say that it was done. If it's not done, then it's really important for you as the owner or the operator or the manager to call up Shirley, who was the shift manager, and say, hey, you said that this trash was all emptied. It wasn't emptied. It was actually initialed by you. I had to take time out of my shift to go and empty all of these trash cans. It can't be done. So can you please make sure that that doesn't happen anymore? If you can't manage your shift effectively, then we'll have to find someone else to do it. I can't stress this enough. If you are an absentee owner, this is almost like the Bible for you to go by. These systems and accountabilities, the system's important, the accountability is more important. Now, there might be a situation where these guys were just absolutely slammed the whole day shift and it just kept going into the night. So there's two ways that you can do this. You can either have them write a note, really slammed, sorry, smiley face. And at least that gives me the idea that if some of these weren't completed, okay, I'm getting some feedback here that they really had a busy shift and they couldn't do it. This is better than initialing it and not doing it or just simply leaving it blank. You've got to make people accountable for the lists and the tasks that you task them for. So regardless of whether it be an open procedure, a closed procedure, a mid-shift procedure, you really need to make sure that the list is there, that they can initial that list, and then they're accountable for it at the end of the shift. So what happens is we wipe this thing down at the end of the day, get my towel here, wipe it down, don't write on it with a permanent marker for Pete's sake, you'll strangle someone. I didn't really mean that. I wouldn't strangle anybody. So that's now ready for the next shift. So again, it's a simple procedure, but a lot of stores just rely on a list for the employees and the managers to go by. And a list is just a piece of paper or a wish list. Gotta laminate it, gotta have them sign off, gotta make them accountable. Simple procedure. It's gonna save you a lot of time and heartache, let me tell you. Again, thank you for tuning in. Thank you very much for our episode sponsor, Carpegiani. Information down below. Keep on scooping. See you in the next video.